لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين أحمدك ربي على كل قضائك وجميع قدرك حمد الرضا بحكمك لليقين بحكمتك وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم Brothers, sisters, Islam, sisters and our beloved viewers Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and ahlan wa sahlan and welcome to our program I'd like to dedicate that program to our viewers, our permanent viewers, those who are always watching our program, and our new Muslims, people who revert to Islam, and our non-Muslim viewers who are always watching, and they meet me and they put some compliment on our program, and I thank you so much. I'm very sorry because we just talk some Islamic words and Arabic words here. Just come because this is an Islamic station, so I'll try, inshallah, to avoid that. Inshallah, may Allah make it easy for you, and may Allah guide all mankind to straight path, inshallah. Muslim brothers and sisters in Islam, we are the follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Without him, we are on dalal. Without Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are not on the sirat al-mustaqim. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave us Quran and gave us the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why I'm saying that? Because I got some of the comment here and some response from our brothers. They say, is that mentioned in Quran? Why are you saying that? I never heard it before. Why you say that? Because there was not haram. I think it's makruh. Maybe we don't prefer it. Our Nabi doesn't prefer it. I want to tell my sisters and my brothers, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam authority to prohibit or to allow. Because Quran al-Kareem give you a general command, but the details is there on the sunnah. So sunnah to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Allah, Jibreel alayhi salam brought it to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we got two resources. The first one is Quran and sunnah. So nowadays in YouTube and messages come here, this hadith is weak, this hadith is not authentic, I'm not sure about this hadith, especially those who are a bit clever and they want to investigate and want, no problem, you can investigate, but I want to tell you, my son and my daughter, there are a hadith is equal to haram and halal, we have to accept. Not every hadith is weak. And you know what is the meaning of weak? Weak on narration. So when the narrator is a bit weak, it doesn't mean it's incorrect. The hadith ul mawdu', you're talking about mawdu', the fabricated one, the fake one. But hadith weak, when we say weak, it's weak on the narrator who is not knowing. There is some narrators got a little bit of error. Or the matin itself, the text itself, the words itself, you got some. But that hadith for fada'il, for virtues, for mana, for akhlaq, we apply it. You got plenty of hadith like that. So now we're not talking about the weak hadith or the fabricated hadith. We're talking about a correct hadith. You have to get it. You have to apply it in your life because you're going to be punished. It's not nasiha, it's not advice. Like our Nabi recommended, our Nabi asked you to do, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. But what about is nahan Nabi, prohibition. Our Nabi forbid. Ma ataakum ar-rasulu fakhudhu wa ma nahakum anhu fantahu. This is an ayah on Quran. Now what are you going to say about this ayah now? Whatever Prophet, Allah said that. Whatever he give you, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is the most high example. Let me give you an example. When the father going for Hajj, inshallah may Allah write for all our parents, Hajj Mabrur, or traveling, or the mother leaving, and he said, you must listen to everything your elder brother or elder sister saying it to you. Whatever I ask you, you must listen to him. So now the father gave authority to the elder brother or sister to tell you, sleep now. No, my mother didn't say that. No, but she gave me permission to control you. Now you must off the light. Don't watch the TV. You must go eat like this. Don't open this. Don't stay here. Don't open the door for the stranger. So this one here from the parents, but Allah handed to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and our Nabi can make nahi. Nahi is prohibition or forbid you. So when you read the hadith, it's called Naha Nabiyyu sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You must know it is from Allah through Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is amr. It is a command. It's instruction. You do it, you will be punished. You will be. Don't say makruh, tanzihi, makruh. Don't say like that. It's a command of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Ask any alim or any mufti will tell you what is the hadith start with. Naha al-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Naha, it means instructed not to do. Because our deen is about do and not to do. The main issue of that, or that nahi, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala command me, ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. You must obey Allah for what he said in Quran, and obey Rasul for what he said in the Sunnah. Right. A music. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid it. You can't say it's a good music and bad music. It's not me now. It's not me. I'm just mentioning what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. If you want from the Quran you get, from the Sunnah you get, ma'azif. So there is a big difference between sami'a and tasamma'a. The hadith talking about tasamma'a, listening deliberately, attentively, to change with the remote, and you find that is tasamma'a. But I'm on a mall, or I'm on a taxi, or on a bus, or on the street, and someone on the music, I didn't listen. But when you choose the channel and you buy that thing, now you tasamma'a. So Allah is very merciful when he instructed us not to listen attentively, to hear on the street. Like you're sitting on a car and then another car got that music. What must I do? There's no lead for my ears to close it like my eyes. So that is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in Quran, فَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنِ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. Listen attentively, not اسمعوا, just hear. Right. In Surah Al-Luqman you got one ayah, and you Surah Al-Furqan you got ayah, Surah Al-Qasas you got ayah. That is about the music. Now we got something very, very important you must share with me about that haircut. I don't know, do you call it marines or that cut? I don't know the name of that cut. You got they shave here and shave here and make that hair up like that. May Allah grant our children hidayah. They ask, is that halal or haram? You say, Naha Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam anil qaza'. What is qaza'? To shave some of the hair and leave the other. Now, if like that, is qaza'. So naha. Naha means prohibited, not allowed. No, Sheikh, it's a style. You say, we don't want to talk about copying the disbeliever or the non-Muslim. I'm talking about that act itself. Even if you don't copy the soccer player or the movie star, I'm talking about the act itself. Is not allowed in Islam to shave some and leave the some, or to make one big and different lengths or level. Right. Naha, Nabi, you saw, naha. You must learn this word, naha. Not advice, not didn't like, he didn't recommend. Is naha. Instructed people not to do it. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يروع مسلم مسلما ولو بالمزاح. You're not allowed to terrorize Muslim, terrorize another Muslim even as a joke. You get a plastic snake, you know, all that that thing there, the, what you call the, so they call it social experiments or whatever there. You can't hide his belongings. You can't just try to terrorize him and make him frightened. It's not recommended to leave. It's haram. Not allowed. Not allowed. Imam Malik, he lashed these people. He lashed them. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited to blow in a hot cup, the hot drink. You blow like that, you're not allowed to do that. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you want to ask me why, we're going to make another program for why. Because you can't ask the doctor when he give you medicine why is 3 tablets. But there is a medical explanation, and there is also a sunnah explanation. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala guide us to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and avoid whatever he disagree with, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister Islam. And once again, we say shukran that you're tuning to our program. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant our children hidayah. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us obedience to Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from any disobedience to Rasul Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the break, I was mentioning some of the prohibition or something which our Nabi instructed us not to do it. You will be punished if you're doing that. It's not advice or it's not even a recommendation. It is instruction. It is a command of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you're not allowed to blow on the hot drinks. And Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid me and you not to look too much in the mirror at night. Look at the mirror at night. Now, before the break, someone is going to ask why. Say, we're going to give you explanation, because in you, you are not only body, you are spirit, you are nafs, you got shaitan, you got jinn. So our Islam said, don't look at night so much on mirror. At night. And there's a dua for that mirror. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you to kill the frog, dead frog. فَإِنَّ نَقِيقُهَا تَسْبِيح. If you find the frog in your yard, in your house, nicely take it and keep it away. Because that noise or that sound of the frog is dhikrullah. Why and how, we'll talk later on, because I don't have time for explaining you why. Because I got plenty and I have to mention it. Next one, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed me and you that we not allow to cause tahrish between the animal and birds. What tahrish? Instigate and causing fight between animals, two dogs or two cows or two birds or two rooster or chicken to fight, as we see there on TV. That is not allowed in Islam. What about human being? What about if you say, boy, hit that boy, I want to see who's who don't. We got wrestling, halal wrestling. But that, the way we see the people are killing one another like that, if it's not allowed between the animal, what about the human being? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited us not to kill the ant, naml. Why? Ummah, to sabbah. Allah treated as a nation. You got the neighbor of Nabi Sayyidina Abu Darda. Nabi Dawood, Allah blame him because he burned the houses of the ant. Allah give wahi to this, so we not allowed. What should we do? You must try to block the way to come and to put, as the, my mother used to put sesame or to read Surah An-Naml and you blow it somewhere, but you're not allowed to kill the ant. Nahl, the peas, honey peas, also, this is not allowed because it is a shifa. When the peas bite you, it's from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Hudhud, the wood picker, not allowed to kill it. This hudhud here got a special care on Deenul Islam. You never find hudhud, that wood picker, on the street dead. Right, and then there's something is called sird. Sird is a coloring sparrow. I don't know in English what you call that sird. Sird is a car, you know, the green sparrow, the small bird, yeah. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited us, do not sleep on the stomach. Do not sleep on the stomach. It's not advice, it's a command of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, because inside the stomach is your life, all the organs of life. Plus, it's daj'atu ahli an-nar, it is the sleeping of the people of Jahannam. Allah doesn't like it. So before you ask me why, Allah doesn't like that one. Finish now. I don't want to say about the stomach problem, heart problem, the inside problem. Allah doesn't like it. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited ummah on the mosque, do not sit and tie your finger like this. You're not allowed to in the mosque. You're not allowed. Don't do that one here, because it's also the sitting of the people of Jahannam. That's narrated on Tirmidhi. So that brother is going to fight. All right. We're not allowed to kill the snake inside the house. Make a plan. You give a warning first, three warning, and take it out and kill it out of the yard. But if it's in the yard on the street, you can kill. Right. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you not to make ever something is called najash. What is najash? A fake auction. In the auction, you find three customer, and you got five, six people in the auction. They are not buying and selling. And then they increasing the auction on the price, 5, 16, 17, and he's not buying. That person here will be punished, because he excite and raise the price while he's not willing to buy. It's just they hire him for that. And Nabi Muhammad SAW said, لَا يَبِيعُ أَحَدُكُمْ عَلَى بَيْعِ أَخِي. You can't come and buy something that's already been sold. Ask the alim or the mufti will explain to you what is that. وَلَا يَخْطِبُ أَحَدُكُمْ عَلَى خِطْبَةِ أَخِي. You can't propose a girl which already been proposed to someone else by putting extra dowry, or you put more money on, try to instigate and break that type of marriage. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited the people that you make tanazzuh of bawl. What is tanazzuh? Those who urinating standing, those urinating while they're in front of one another, doesn't hide his body, or does not clean himself from urine properly. He will get punished in the grave, not only on akhirah, in the grave. Our Nabi does not allow the people to do that. Our children in the school and on the mall and all that un-Islamic toilet, you see what they're doing. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you to pull the gray hair. That gray hair on your body doesn't mean that you're going to die, or doesn't mean that you become ugly or you're old. No, that is a ni'mat of Allah, that you're already getting enough age under the shade of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam asked Allah, what is that? He said, is a waqar. Ibrahim is waqar, is a dignity and respect. See, Allah give me more. And subhanallah, you pull one, Allah will punish you for the other five. They're going to come same day. Then Allah will never punish a person who get a gray hair in Islam. So we must make shukr that we got that gray hair, and Allah will never punish us, because we are so long in Islam. We live long till our hair like this. Right. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited men, do not hit your wife. There's nothing is called beating the wife. And the wife, don't allow your husband to beat you. I'm seeing it on the TV now. Not allowed at all. Kadaba, you hit your wife. And then not only that, and you're not allowed to criticize the feature of your wife. You're ugly, you look like what? You're finding faults in her body, and then you go sleep with her after that. What type of relationship that? So that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said like that. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't allow me and you to sleep half on the shade and half on the sun. You know, the shade on the sun, you know, you get sitting there, you put your leg on the sun and your head on the shade. No, that is why, because they changing the mood of the person, the heat and cold causing a problem there. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam prohibited me and you to urinate on the shower while you are taking a shower. It's not allowed because you make the place dirty. And then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam does not allow me and you to urinate and pass, relieve yourself under the shade of the tree or in the water or the shade of the wall, because people can use it. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam prohibited me and you to shout and swear the rooster, the chicken which is making adhan. You tell her, shut up, what are you doing? Hey, I'm a noise. It is waking, is adhan and dhikrullah. You must say subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. It's a ni'mah when you have a chicken making like this, remind you about dhikrullah. It's actually, you'll get ajr for that. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam prohibited me and you not to insult and speak bad about the fever. When your body gets hot, don't say, I got a terrible fever. No, because it is kafara, it is repenting, is a type of tawbah. Allah decided to remove all your guna and your sin from that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from anything which displease Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Short break, continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we say shukran that you're always tuning to our program. I'd like to thank all our viewers in Cape Town. Jazakallah khayran for that lovely feedback. I'm very proud of my viewers in Cape Town. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use our ITV as a unity of the ummah and as a gathering of khair, inshallah. May Allah make it easy for all of you. And I'd like to thank Brother Abdul Rahman from Durban. Shukran jazilan for your comment. You're always encouraging me to choose the topic. May Allah reward you. And our elderly mom and dad, those who are watching us, I'm very glad that the boys, they come and say, my mom is watching and my grandmother. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. And may Allah reward all our sisters who are always listening and practice that. I'm very proud of our sisters who use our ITV as a means of knowledge and means of education. May Allah make it easy, inshallah. On your behalf, I'd like to thank my cameraman, my editors, my sound engineer, our lovely boys behind the camera. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it easy for them, inshallah. Now we continue with the prohibition or the things which our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam strictly doesn't allow the ummah to do it, and it's equal to the haram. It's called naha. Naha means forbid or to stay away or abstain from that type of. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid and prohibited the children to play on the time of Maghrib time, because it's a time of spreading the shaitan. Yes, you must call your child from the yard, from the street, on the time of Adhan al-Maghrib, and then after that you can release them. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited the ummah that you mustn't get used to the anger. People got short temper. Ask those who divorce, ask those who lost their job, those who lost their friends because of anger. La taghdab, do not get angry. Because that anger can cause big problem, you can't fix it. See the angry man when he divorced his wife 3 times. Shame, we feel sorry for him because he's looking for solution. You should wait that he can hold. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited the person to make salah like a crow. Crow is knocking the ground. Speedy salah is not allowed. That he said to that person, Salli fa innaka lam tusalli. Pray again because you did not pray. You can't knock the salah, sajda, quick like this. You have to give time for your sujood and ruku' and salah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam naha, prohibited us, idkhal al-ta'am ala al-ta'am. You can't eat while you are full. Ask the doctor, they will tell you what is the story of that. You're filling your stomach, It's the biggest problem. Half of the medication now, stop eating. Avoid that food. Because of إدخال الطعام على الطعام. نحن قوم, we are such people, our Prophet ﷺ said, لا نأكل حتى نجوع. We don't eat till we feel hungry. وإذا أكلنا, and when we eat, we don't get full. To be angry again. Or the children complain food because they are not hungry. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited us, do not choose the seat and place while you are the guest. Wait till the owner of the house, the host, to choose for you. The owner of the house says, sit here, say, no, I want to sit here, to check the kitchen there or the bedroom. Wait. Look at this. The deen of Islam is a deen of etiquette, a deen of manner and respect. Not only that, if the owner of the house doesn't want to let you get in, don't come inside. وَإِنْ قِيلَ لَكُمْ إِرْجِعُوا فَارْجِعُوا. If it's been said to you in any type of way, go away, you must go away. Now, alhamdulillah, we don't say go away. Now, I was talking on a bayan somewhere, and then we find our brothers and sisters say, I saw the TV was on. Yeah, but the owner of the house doesn't want, is not ready to welcome. He's fighting with his wife. He's not on the mood. Now, he doesn't have food. He doesn't have it. Now, they talk about hospitality, looking after the guest. Yeah, that when he enter. When I allow you to enter, now you must ask me about hospitality, a warm welcome, a nice khidmat, a good face, no problem. But once you're outside, khalas, that lady that is not in the mood to welcome, the house is untidy, they're not in the mood. فَرْجِعُوا ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَكُمْ. That is good for you. One sahabi used to knock to get that good. What that good is, I want someone to say irji'u. Now we got a different type of irji'u. He said, no, I saw someone there from the window. Yes, it's irji'u. He never heard. You knock, they don't want to answer. Walk away. Why? Nothing. Nothing to do with you. Go walk away. Finish. No, Sheikh, it's not good. These people are very stingy. They don't have respect. He said, the man of the house is fully free to let you in or to go. Even the police don't get in without permission. If you want to even arrest someone, you can't. Buyutun maskuna, the privacy, the confidential life of the Muslim is very important. So yeah, you can't choose the place in the house and you can't force the people to open for you. Right. You're not allowed to sit, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited us, not allowed to sit between two people. This man and that man, they are talking, say, take me in the middle. No, you're not allowed. Because maybe they are talking something, right? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not allow me and you to whisper in front of the third person. Why? لا يتناجى إثنان. You can't make munajat, you talk. Now we can say you talk another language. You took some other sign language or you whisper like this, because this man here, you're going to have huzun. You will suspect. You will think that you talk about him. If I come to your house and you talk Afrikaans to your wife, I say, oh, these people here, they say, take the sheikh and throw him away from the window. I don't know. Shaitan will come and give us a wrong thought. So what you do? If there are four, no problem. Why? Because not me, is that man. It's the next one. You're going to say like that. So, that one, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, listen to this one here, does not permit the men and women to length or to make the nails longer. That women who got this one or to make one nails, not allowed. Ask the doctor to see how much dirt and how much bacteria got that nails here. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave us also a warning, right, for what? That you're not allowed to free the unwelcome hair on your body, the armpit and other part, more than 40 days. You're not allowed. It's going to be a sickness and also you won't be a fully clean. So the fitrat of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never ever allow you to sleep while the people are awake amongst the jalisin. Everyone is awake and talking, and you sleep there on the middle. Our children or our brothers or our father, Jesus take a nap there next to you. Say, La, in Islam we don't allow that. Uncle, go to your bed. We'll call you, inshallah. No, I'm not sleeping. You say, you're sleeping on set up. Come. Wake up and set properly. And then, وَتَجْلِسُ بَيْنَ النَّائِمِينَ, and you sit amongst the sleeping people. All the people are asleep and you are awake. No, you must take a side. That's called Islamic manner. And it's, you will be punished for that. Naha, as I said, naha. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, naha to sleep while you are impure. What you do if you are lazy, which we supposed to take a shower after you have that, what you call the intercourse with your husband, you have to take a shower to read Fajr. No problem. Why we make ghusl for the mayyit? Because of that. We do not sure that this person is clean or not. So, or you go make wudu. If you are not interested in ghusl now, you go and make wudu and you come back. So that, to just stay like that without wudu, that is manhi anhu, not allowed in the religion of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us, make it easy for us to practice all of that, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. And once again, we say shukran for your emails, SMSs, and phone calls. I'd like to make a special dua for our imams and our muadzin for that wonderful work on the month of Ramadan. I'm very, very proud of our huffaz and our qurra. May Allah reward you. And make a special dua for those children who fasted Ramadan for the first time. May Allah grant you the ajr, and may Allah reward your parents. And shukran jazilan for that you always our ITV and our program, inshallah. We still continue with the nahi, the prohibition of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in certain action. You're not allowed to do it. Nahi, it means not allowed, is not halal, you will be punished for it. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam naha, prohibited person to hit the animal or any creation on the face, on the stomach, on a private part. You're not allowed to hit. To hit the dog, or the chicken, or the sheep, or the human being, we're not allowed to hit at all. He's not allowed to hit. Right, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited person to search for his missing thing inside the mosque. In shadow dallah, asking, searching for his missing thing and screaming and saying, who did see my stuff? You have to, there's a notice board there. You have to ask the muadzin, but the imam also can do it, but not the musalli. Because it happened in the time of Rasulullah SAW, someone said, who saw my red camel? So our Nabi did not like that, and he forbid the person. And actually, he's making dua that he mustn't find that type of camel. Right, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam prohibited me and you to make qasam with something besides Allah. So that is a very serious now. Half. Half is a qasam or yameen. We got wallahi, billahi, tallahi. You can get this one of these three. Wallahi, billahi, tallahi. Now the qasam is about two things. About the past, to free yourself from responsibility. Very serious one. And qasam for the future, that 1 year, if you don't do it, you make kafara to yameen. And if you make hanth, you want to break this 1 year, you have to pay, and you have to fast, and you have to feed the people. But the dangerous one is about the past. Did you break that phone? Wallahi, is not me. That one, it's called yameenul ghamus. That qasam, which dipping you in the fire of Jahannam. So teach your children, speak the truth, don't take the name of Allah, don't put Allah on that lies on the qasam, because there's no kafara for it. If someone said, no, Allah, I didn't do it, you must say, la ilaha illallah, quickly and wait. They call it mu'allaq. Mu'allaq, it means we'll wait on the day of Qiyamah if Allah accept or not. But this is a most dangerous qasam when you talk about the past. I never do. If you speak the truth, no problem. But what about you lie on that qasam? Now we'll come for our biggest problem in South Africa, when the people say Quran qasam. This is not a qasam. Actually, you have to say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Quran is a makhluq. Quran is a kalam of Allah, but that kitab, that pages here, it's a paper. So you can't say Quran or qasam because you didn't make the qasam. We know that Quran is kalam of Allah, but when you make qasam, you make qasam by wallahi billahi tallahi. But you touch the Quran, you take the page like this, and you kiss it and you make like that, that page is makhluq, is an object. I know the kalam of Allah is not makhluq, it's from ever, it's kalamullah, but the qasam is wallahi billahi tallahi. And we don't accept in it. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid. Not allowed even to sell and buy by the qasam. Wallahi is a genuine, Allah is a cost price, wallahi I'm not lying. You can't. That bayya'ul halaf, the seller by using this, actually making qasam too much is a sign of hypocrisy. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh, I got here qasam by the grave of my father. I'd never heard that before, but I swear by my father, I swear by Sheikh Wat or Maulana Wat. I swear by my akhirah. No. You can't do. Wallahi billahi tallahi. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you to believe on something. It's called tayra. Bad luck, superstition. I saw black cat, black dog. I saw the bird was there by my window. I saw the tayra. It means you seek or you expect bad luck by some action or some object. You're going to buy something and you find a black. I don't know why you say black cat, you are racist or what, why black, not red. They say no, like I don't, we got a problem with the color black. You got a black market, you're black male, you're black what, I don't know what's wrong. The color, Nabi Adam alayhi salam was a black. The moon appear on a black. I'm not here to praise the plague or whatever, but I'm just telling you who put that words here. Plague, magic, plague, what? What I'm trying to say here, there's no tayra fil Islam. In qalu inna tatayyarna bikum. We find bad luck when we see. We got so many of our friends, they said, since that girl married in our family, many people died. Hey, this lady is a bad luck. Since I move from this house to another house, hey, I'm getting sick. That is tayra, not allowed. You'll be punished for that thought. That everything run with the taqdeer of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Like you people say the black cat is a jinn, or the black dog is a jinn. Even if he's a jinn, but he's a dog now. He's a dog, you catch the dog, you kill the jinn. So, la tayrata fil Islam. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited mujahideen, a war people, soldiers, fighter, do not abuse the body of the killed or the murdered person. You kill in the battlefield, you're not allowed to torture and abuse the body. Do not kill women, do not kill children, do not break the church and synagogue. Do not cut the trees, do not kill the animals, do not destroy the well and rivers, do not attack them at night, do not break the cross on the church, do not terrorize those who have peaceful people in their homes, fight those who fight you only. That it's called Naha Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the ghazwa, on the battle. Now if you heard this, you think that we are terrorists. Even Allah show mercy in a time of fight, that you can't terrorize a priest or the worshiper on his temple. We know that he's wrong, but we're not allowed to criticize the religion of the other. Because you make sab الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ, you insult those who are associating partner with Allah. They will insult Allah بغير علم. They will send the shouting or the insulting back to Allah. So you're causing a problem. So we have to respect. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited me and you to enter the house which only got a female, not mahram, non-mahram. You visit your friend, you find only his wife there. Stay outside. No, she's my sister, we grow up together, we trust. No. Haram. No, Sheikh, you think that you're suspecting us, you always accuse us. My Nabi said, don't go. It's more safer. It's good for you. Don't enter. And it's an instruction. It's not Sheikh's word or the nasiha. It's a nahi. It's a nahi. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited person not to enter, to be the first one who entered the market or the last one who leave the market. That is not allowed because it's shayateen. There is a jinn and shayateen on that time, if it's not necessary. Right. Do not insult the wind. Make dua. Wind is from Allah. So when you find wind, you say you got a bad wind. Allahumma inni as'aluka khayraha. Allah asks, wa'udhu bika min sharriha. You make dua, Allah save me from the evil. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you, do not sleep after adhan al-asr. That time here, wake up your children. If you are sick or in hospital, but I'm talking about the normal person like me and you, don't choose because it is affecting your brain, your mood and your brain, it will affect you. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you that you must not describe the beauty of some women at all, even if you are women. So now your wife was sitting with another man's wife, she's covered. Then he said she's got a blonde hair, she got a green eye. No, you're not allowed here because she's wearing barda to hide that. Now you're taking that picture and you gave it to the people. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is our deen. This is our sharia. This is our rules done by Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, from where you get this one? I get it from hadith. Maybe the hadith, he said, not every hadith is incorrect. We got Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih al-Muslim. So Sahih, it means correct. So what I'm trying to say, مَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from any haram. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it easy to obey Allah and to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rabbana innana sami'na munadiyan yunadi lil iman yan aminu bi rabbikum fa amanna. Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Shukran jazilan. Till we see you inshallah next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا